What's up, y'all? Welcome. I want to talk about some things. So, what I'm going to be doing is a 9-part series talking about modern men and modern women. I'll be talking mostly about women to men. So, if anybody feels some type of way about me being misogynistic or whatever y'all want to call me, well, then speak your peace. I'm a straight man. I'm into women. So, naturally, what I'm going to complain about? Women. All right? For y'all straight women out there, I'm pretty sure that whatever I do say, y'all gonna say the exact opposite of what I got to say. And I encourage you to speak it because I don't care. I don't date men. You know what I'm saying? I don't even have male friends like that. You know what I'm saying? So if you gonna say something, if you're gonna jump into the video and be like, what about men? What about men? Tell me about them. I don't date men. Tell me about them. I'm gonna complain about women because that's what I'm into. You're into men? Complain about men. Let me know. Straight up. You might put me on game. I'm not expecting that you would, but it could happen anywho's. Part one of part nine. All right. Now, there it is again. Right there. Anywho's, what I was going to say is that most women actually run their men off. I know people be trying to act like men are just no good, cheating, stick their penis in anything and slide off to the side, abusive, whatever you want to call it. That does happen, that's true, but that is not the majority of the case. We live in a generation where people take the minority and try to apply it to the majority if it's beneficial for them in a negative way. What I'm trying to say is that it's more beneficial for y'all to try to make men seem like that and then say this is the reason why relationships between modern women and modern men are broken is because men are these things. That does happen, but that's the minority. Most men are not even that sexually active. Like, for real. And most men actually will go out their way to show respect to any random woman. But the primary way that women be running their men off is by being disrespectful in too many forms. Now, if you deal with disrespect long enough over a certain amount of time, if you have any sense, you'd be like, no, I'm gone. Why would you sit up and be disrespected over any period of time? Well, you could just be by yourself, or you could be around people who will show you more respect or disrespect you less. All right. Now, the first way that women disrespect men is by being ungrateful and unappreciative, all right? Because the same way women need attention, it's the same way men need respect, all right? Now, men understand that in this world, nothing's free because the masculine world and the feminine world are two different things. To have a complete world, you got to bring the masculine and feminine together. That's why it says, for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cling to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Masculine and feminine come together, complete world, okay? Now, most men living in a man's world, because this is a man's world, because the way things are, you'll see how harsh things are as a man as opposed to a female. You know what I'm saying? Really? To be real, you could be ugly as a woman. Just don't be fat. A lot of y'all women, being a woman comes with natural privileges because people feel more sympathy for you as a woman than they would for a man, you know? So as a woman, a lot of times, most of you women, y'all could be ugly, all that. Just don't be fat. And shoot, some man will really put his life on the line to be with you until he dies. Stuff is crazy. Now, what I was going to say is that women don't be showing proper appreciation or respect to men when men do things for them because they don't really understand what it's like as a man in this world. If you get something from somebody, you be like, yo, this stuff didn't come free. Somebody had to pay for this, even though I don't have to pay for it. You know what I'm saying? When somebody else does something for you as a man, you be like, I appreciate that because I understand what it's like to stop what you're doing or put what you got on hold to come over here and do what you do for me. A lot of times women don't have that sort of appreciation or respect. They give out the fakest thank yous in the world. When I do things for people, right, I feel more, I believe that men are more sincere when I do something for them, even though they only say, like, appreciate it, bro, or good looking out, thanks, man, or something like that. But then women, they try to go into this whole little let me be nice thingy, and it's just so fake that you can tell they don't appreciate it. They be like, oh, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Okay, you have a good day. Like, they just be fake as a mug. You know why? Because they don't understand what it's like to live a life based on respect and disrespect. You know what I'm saying? Even as a man. You know what I'm saying? If I say something if I say the wrong thing to a man, I could be in a fist fight. Like, really though, man, I could be out here getting beat up by some dude because I said something crooked to him. Women don't understand that kind of stuff. They be out here talking super foul to men because they rarely ever get hit. You know? But when a man does something for a woman, she just isn't appreciative or grateful. And then more often than that, when a man says, you know what, this broad, she don't even appreciate nothing that I do. I'm going to go ahead and do less. Not do nothing, I'm going to do less. Because a lot of times men just have this guilty conscience. That's why men are easily guilt tripped, because they have a guilty conscience already. They be like, well, I can't stop doing this or stop doing that. Why can't you? Because that's a bull stuff excuse. If she don't appreciate what you're doing, stop doing it. Because that's exactly what she's going to do to you. All right? Now then, women are more likely to guilt trip a man into doing something than a man is to guilt trip a woman into doing something. You know why? Because they don't really appreciate what, they don't really have respect or appreciate what men do for them. All they care about is, can they get something done? All right? All right, Ruff. I be clowning dogs. All right, so that's the first way. All right. Now, the second way, there's plenty of ways. I shot this video like 3 times. Phone kept going off. I'm forgetting what I'm talking about now. I'm about done. All right, another way that women run their men off is by being disrespectful. Is that they start ego tripping. They start getting egotistical. And I found that when a woman gets her a stable job and her some good money, when she starts doing her thing, start doing her adulthood thing, or when she gets married, or she gets kids, or she gets comfortable in a long-term relationship, women, they just start having this attitude as if, well, if I get fat on you, or if I start treating you like this, what are you going to do? You know what I'm saying? Women be basically daring men to leave them. And if they actually do it, guess what? Guess who's the monster? Men. Stuff is crazy as a mug. So women, they just start, they get a job, and they start acting like because they got money, rather they have more money or less money than the men, the fact that they have their own, they be like, well, I don't have to show you no respect. You know what I'm saying? I can go ahead and start acting masculine. You know? And I can start treating you like this and treating you like that because I got money, so I don't have to depend on you. Wrong. A man isn't going to see you as coming up. He's going to see you as disrespectful. Because men don't care about what women do besides what they do for them. On a sexual, romantic level, men don't care about your jobs. They don't care about who you know. They don't care about what you've done. They care about mostly where you've been and what you're doing. Like, what kind of person have you been? What kind of person are you now? And can I get down with you? Men don't really care about all that. So some women, they let money, status, and stuff like that get to their brain. And they start acting, they start ego tripping and power tripping. And then men start seeing them. Well, my opinion is that men start seeing women like that as masculine. You know, so then they dip, because for you to switch it up or to be masculine, it's pointless. You know what I'm saying? Why would a masculine man be with a masculine woman? That don't make no sense. You know what I'm saying? That's disrespectful. Another way that women run their men off by being disrespectful is that when they have kids, they start changing too. They start having an attitude. A lot of times when a woman has kids with a man, when the kids are watching, she'll try to stun on the man. You know what I'm saying? It gets to the point where the man can't even ask his woman, the mother of his children, to do things or tell her to do things. Because every time you tell her or ask her to do something, she wanna fight them back in front of the kids. A lot of men are men everywhere except for in their own house. They go to work, they're men. They go everywhere else, and they try to give off this masculine vibe, and they go home and get punked by their fat wife and disrespected by their big, snotty-nosed, ugly kids. You know what I'm saying? So, it happens a lot. I know what I just said was pretty harsh. The reason why I said that so casually, because it happens so often, is just that people do not be keeping it real. That's why I'm talking about the things that I'm talking about, all right? And then when you get disrespected, that's one thing. Men are very sensitive. Everybody has fragile egos. One thing that men are fragile or egotistical about is being disrespected in front of their whatchamacallits, in front of people that they find as respectable or respectful. I'm telling you, it's whenever you busy, everybody want to like, dude. Whenever you busy, everybody want to be by you and near you. Or whenever you don't want to be bothered by people, that's when everybody want to be in your face. Anywho's, so what I was talking about is that men don't like being disrespected in front of people that he respects or think he's a respectable person. So when a woman starts disrespecting a man in front of his kids, that really hurts his soul. And then most men will stick into that relationship and try to show them, but then it gets and try to show the kids like, nah, that's all right. Don't be like your mama, be like me. But that don't work. especially if the woman is disrespecting the man in front of his daughters. That ain't gonna work. It ain't gonna work for real, because they see mommy doing it, they be like, well, kids don't know no better. They be like, well, if mommy does it and get away with it, why come every time I tell you no, or every time I ignore you, or every time I talk back to you, you want to put me in the corner or spank me? But when mommy do it, all you do is scream and walk off. You know what I'm saying? And then I'm trying to think another way. Because I'm telling you, everything I'm about to say is going to be about how women show men disrespect. A lack of proper respect. Because really though, if you show a man proper respect and appreciation, if you show most men proper respect and appreciation, you could get nearly anything that you want out of a man if you show him proper respect and appreciation. Like really though, genuine respect and appreciation, that's how you get things out of men in general. Like for real, if you do that, most of the time a man tells you no about something, he really don't have it, or maybe he's going through something in his personal life. But generally, show a man proper respect and appreciation, you get nearly anything you want out of a man if you do that. All right? So, another way that women run their men off by being disrespectful is actually talking crazy about men, the male gender. The same way I'm speaking right now, if this video blows up on YouTube, you know majority of the comment section, because I leave my comment sections open. I'm not scary like that. You get what I'm saying? I don't really care, man. Maybe I'm stupid. Maybe I should hide my face and not talk about things like this. But I just don't really care. You know what I'm saying? I want people to know that if I said something, I said it. Because I'm not the type of person that'd be like, yo, no, I didn't say it. You know what I'm saying? Like, shoot, if I don't want to, if the consequences for me speaking in this video are more than I can bear, I'm still going to take them. That's why I put my face in these videos. Man, I ain't scared of nobody like that. Straight up. Y'all do what y'all want. Now, the way I'm talking about women, right? They're going to be labeling me a misogynist because the way I'm talking about women. Because anytime you say anything about a woman that isn't complimentary, it's automatically misogyny. That's crazy. But women do the same thing about men. And what I found is that most men complain about women the way I'm complaining about women. You see my voice tone. You see the way I'm speaking and everything else. Just another thing. But women, they be furious when they complain about men. A lot of women be really dogging men out. And these women, they be having sons. This stuff be crazy. So women sitting up talking crazy about men is what run their men off, especially if the man is already involved with the women. Because if he has any sense, he be thinking like, yo, if this is what she thinks about women, I mean, if this is what this woman thinks about men, it's only a matter of time before she start talking about me like that or start treating me like that. That's exactly what I could understand about women who say that men are misogynists. But I'm just being honest. I'm not saying a bunch of negative things. Women be talking about men are dogs. Men are this and that. They ain't no good. Women are better than what you out here for. Why you got sons? This stuff is crazy out here. So, and another thing that another thing that women do to run off men by being disrespectful is not keeping it real. You know, I know some folks be saying that you gotta say things a certain way. You gotta be tactful. You gotta care about people's feelings. But women don't really do that with men. Here comes a fire truck. Oh, right outside the fire station too. Anywho's, I'm about to go. The park is right there. I'm about to go hoop right there. I'm fat. I'm about to lose this weight. But anywho's, another way that women do that stuff is that they act like men are evil and women are good. And then women would be disrespectful and talk crazy to men or about men and not care about their feelings. But then when a man says anything to a woman, the first thing he has to do is mandatory that you take the woman's feelings into regard. But they don't show that proper respect back. That's not keeping it real. That's hypocritical and being fake. And that's what run men off, because that's just fake. You know? Another thing that women do that's disrespectful to run off their men is kind of like the same thing I just explained, is lying. They lie about their sexual history. They lie about their relationships with other people. And then they lie about certain things that they did throughout the relationship, because nobody's perfect, right? But you think that it's respectable to lie to people or to sugarcoat things, but when you're dealing with a man who's masculine, he takes respect very seriously. And there's nothing more disrespectful than a person you looking you dead in your face and telling you something that they know for a fact is not true. That is very disrespectful. A lot of women lie a lot before their relationships and in their relationships or when they're around men. They lie a lot. And then they get mad at the men and act like you're supposed to understand. And be like, yeah, I understand why you lie. But can you understand why I don't want to be in league with a liar? I don't keep a company of liars. You know what I'm saying? Don't lie to me. You know what I'm saying? And shoot, because I had somebody say this, and he was right. He was a pastor at one of these churches. He said, somebody will lie to you, they'll lie about you. Real spill. All right? Another way that women run their men off is more the same by being disrespectful is faking equality. Yeah. So a man has to do this and have to do that and have to do this and have to do that. And a woman, she just doesn't put her same effort in or put her same. Let me see. Let's say, look here. This is what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to say, look here. If you want to say men and women are equal, but they're better at different things, I completely agree. But I'm going to say, listen, I'm going to say this, though. This is where the equality is. This is what runs men off. Like, if you don't want a man that's broke, right, that's cool. But then if a man doesn't want a woman who's fat and you complain about that, that's not equal. That's fake. That's not equality. You get what I'm saying? And a lot of women, they are hypocrites like that. And then a man would say, you know what? See, the problem is that a lot of men ain't going to address women about these issues. That's why I'm speaking on it. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't even do it. In my personal life, I wouldn't do it. I talk to certain women, but I'm not about to argue with one of you broads. I'm really not. I'm not your boyfriend. I'm not about to argue with one of you broads. Because if y'all do these things I talk about, if y'all show men disrespect over a period of time, he's not going to sit up here and argue with you or try to change you, because that's just not realistic. He's going to leave. This is real life, man. This is real life. This isn't one of those TV shows or movies or whatever else. This isn't a video game. This is real life. Nobody's going to try to love you into another person. If you're disrespectful or if you're a liar, nobody's going to sit around you trying to help you be better like that. They'll help you for a time and then they're gone. I'm telling you. So women, they be acting like men and they act like men and women are equal. But when it comes down to day to day, week by week, month by month, year by year stuff, they don't put up their half. And then men leave because of that. And then a lot of women, they talk crazy about the baby's father. And they use the kids as a weapon against the father. Lying, demonizing the father. Putting some hatred in the heart of the kids for the father. That's the end of the video. I ain't got that much time, but that's how women be running their men off. Part 1 of 9. We out of here. Outro. Show. Yeah. Yeah, we out. Man, forget that. I'm gone. I'm fat.